I've become convinced I'm not alone here, even though I'm equally sure it is simply a delusion brought upon by circumstance. I do not, for instance, remember where I found the candles, or why I took it upon myself to light such a strange pathway. Perhaps it is only for those who are bound to follow.
Well, I came from up there. You haven't actually been down here. Stonehenge! That sounds creepy. So, I've seen a lot of that texture. Where do I live? That's a good question. Do we go... We can go up there. Also, apparently, seems we can go in here. So, if I am alone in this island, what do? How do I sustain myself? Do I ever go back to the mainland, or do I just stay here and live a hermit's life, yet outdoors? Looks like it goes around a corner. Thought it might be a dead end, my good old boy. I didn't go the other way.
Dear Esther, I have now driven the stretch of the M5 between Exeter and Bristol over 21 times. But although I have all the reports and all the witnesses, and have cross-referenced them within a millimeter using my ordnance survey maps, I simply cannot find the location. You'd think there would be marks to serve as some evidence. It's somewhere between the turnoff for Sanford and the welcome break services. But although I can always see it in my rearview mirror, I have as yet been unable to pull ashore.
What is he looking for? A body? Can I also go back? Because there's a way I didn't go. It looks like you almost can, but... I hope there's nothing important back there. Off of this, yeah, it was a way to go up that way. You got an X. Is that just a crisscross of foliage or an X placed there? Like two posts. Oh wow. Oh cool. You know I want to check that out. Let's go this way first. I don't like how you can't go back in some places. I've crossed into the other chapter and there's... Can't go back. A buoy? Back there? Flashing? I think I can go down if I turn around this way.
It's only at night that this place makes any sluggish effort at life. You can see the buoy and the aerial. I've been taking to sleeping through the day in an attempt to resurrect myself. I can feel the last days drawing upon me. There's little point now in continuation. There must be something new to find here. some nook or some cranny that offers a perspective worth clinging to. I've burnt my bridges. I've sunk my boats and watched them go to water.
Is he reaching the end of his life by natural causes, or he just has no will to go on living? I mean, he doesn't sound that old. Awesome. If this was me in real life, I'd be checking all this stuff out. Probably go on the boat and end up crashing through some kind of rusted metal and injuring myself, bleeding to death or something like that. Before I was an explorer in games, I was an explorer in life. And I still am. I don't know if I can go on this boat. It'd be cool if I could climb this rope, but nope. More paint. How much of this paint? Maybe these are the ones who exported the paint. And we decided to use some of it for our own purposes. It's all over the beach. Actually, no. Imported the paint would be the right terminology. Are these boxes full of the paint cans? I'm thinking so. You know I'm going through here. It'd be a great place to weather out a storm if it wasn't so close to the water. I mean, I don't know if this is high tide or low tide. It looks like low tide. Gotta be. I can't go on the boat? What? Come on, man. At least I hope you can't, because I'm going away from it. Just my luck, there's a way on board. If we could jump, I could literally go... Bloop, blop, blop. But no jumping. I'm too old and rickety for that. Looks like could be end of the line over here.
There must be a hole in the bottom of the boat. How else could new hermits have arrived?
I'm guessing he's not talking about hermit crabs. A hole in... No. They need a hole in the bottom of the boat to get here? Well, there was a hole made in the boat which crashed ashore, and then they just had to stay here, or decided they wanted to stay here. Yeah, I've been over here.
I had kidney stones, and you visited me in the hospital.
Oh, that's nice.
After the operation, when I was still half submerged in anesthetic, your outline and your speech both blurred. Now my stones have grown into an island and made their escape, and you have been rendered opaque by the car of a drunk.
Oh. She got hit by a drunk driver. And died?
Is this what Paul saw through his windscreen?
Oh my.
Not Lot's wife looking over her shoulder, but a scar in the hillside falling away to black forever.
Ha 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 ha. You know I gotta jump in, guys. Come back. There's a house. Where did I even come from here? Alright. Bye!
Come back.
It was like he was almost going to be born into a new being. He heard the heartbeat from the sonogram. Was this the way I was traveling? I did see something at the bottom there. I just want to take a quick look back here. I was over there, right? On the other side? I was up there. Playing blind, guys. I don't know. I want to explore all there is to see, but I don't know if we'll get to the, you know, the end of the chapter by going to this house or near it, somewhere beyond maybe. But maybe it's a dead end and we do go back that way. I don't know. I do want to check out the house though, because we're here. Who knows what's the other way? Well, they got two houses. I just want to be able to go back if I, you know, want to. You know, I'm thinking maybe this trail goes back this way. No, this is where I just was. Duh. Yes. Hole of Horrors.
I've begun my ascent on the windless slope of the western side. The setting sun was an inflamed eye squeezing shut against the light shone in by the doctors. My neck is aching through constantly craning my head up to track the light of the aerial. I must look downwards, follow the path under the island to a new beginning.
I like stables. I'd climb that, but I can't get around that way. Oh my. Did someone perform surgery here? Or did someone give birth? Or maybe an animal gave birth? Those are pieces of wood. I thought they were medicine bottles. Pretty. Can I go down there? Looks pretty hazardous. Can't step over things. It's quite disconcerting. Well, I'm supposed to be going this way.
the bothy was constructed originally in the early 1700s.
A bothy?
By then, shepherding had formalized into a career.
What's a bothy?
The first habitual shepherd was a man called Jacobson, from a lineage of migratory Scandinavians. He was not considered a man of breeding by the mainlanders. He came here every summer whilst building the bothy, hoping eventually that becoming a man of property would secure him a wife and a lineage. Donnelly records that it did not work. He caught some disease from his malcontented goats and died 2 years after completing it. There was no one to carve white lines into the cliff for him, either.
So sad. So I'm guessing a bothy is a place where you keep sheep or goats.
When the oil lamps ran out, I didn't pick up a torch, but used the moonlight to read by. When I've pulled the last shreds of sense from it, I will throw Donnelly's book from the cliffs and perhaps myself with it.
Oh.
Maybe it will wash back up through the caves and erupt from the spring when the rain comes, making its return to the hermit's cave. Perhaps it will be back on the table when I wake. I think I may have thrown it into the sea several times before.
Keeps coming back, huh? Well, this guy really doesn't want to go on living, I'll tell you that much. Rather thick tomes. What is it? Right. Trying to read that upside down. A Hebridean history. Well, this would be a nice place to sit and look at the craggy rocks, but the window's all broken. Oh wow. Does someone still live here? Or is this like a place someone formerly lived? Could be either. We should fix up the place though, I tell you that much. At least the door. Maybe stop messing with paint and fix the door. Oh. I'm hungry! I want your meat. What is that supposed to symbolize? Bothy. Just a bothy. Another bothy. What did we burn here? Something burned. Bail notice? Someone's out on bail. What's that? I heard that. Is that in my head? My own skull doing that or something? Sound like static. It was weird. I do want to see what's back that other way, if there's anything. Back past the boats. I might just go have a look. And for you guys, I'll speed up the video. Because that is apparently our destination. We want to head to the transmitter tower. Okay, so it took me about 3 minutes to get back over here. Oh, you're kidding, it ends here anyway. At least we got a good look at the buoy. Yeah, it ends. Oh! Neither did he eat nor drink. Something before that, I'm not sure. And neither... Something neither did he eat nor drink. Written in that luminous paint. What does that mean? Is that me? I don't eat or drink? I mean, could be. I don't see anything to eat or drink. I guess I painted all that? Just for something to do? Because all the luminous paint was apparently aboard that ship. That boat. So we've been making use of it. Ever since. Alright, now I gotta walk all the way back, 3 minutes. Spray enamel. Now we didn't take this way. We went that way. So this is kind of like closer to the rocks here. I don't know if we'll see anything here interesting. Probably not, but I don't know. Is this even the right way? Is this the dead end way? Should we? I think we turn around? Hole of Doom. Oh, we got this here. Ah. Shall I try? We?
They found Jakobsen in early spring. The thaw had only just come. Even though he'd been dead nearly 7 months, his body had been frozen right down to the nerves and had not even begun to decompose. He'd struggled halfway down the cliff path, perhaps looking for some lost goat, or perhaps in a delirium, and expired, curled into a claw right under the winter moon. Even the animals shunned his corpse. The mainlanders thought to bring it home unlucky. Donnelly claims they dragged it to the caves to thaw out and rot. But he is proving an unreliable witness.
Poor guy. There seems to be a lot of sadness here. Assuming this goes back up to that house. But I do definitely want to check all that stuff out down there. I'm surprised I didn't die. Come back. Now I guess if I see a place I can't come back from, like the first time, I don't want to go that way just yet if I have more to explore. Whoa. Well, I feel dangerously close to the edge right now. They have a bridge, or rather, a fence here. Well, number one, it's not completely linear, which is good. in and of itself. Number two, though, we can't travel any faster, so if you want to backtrack, it's a little boring. I just want to take a quick look up here. I'm pretty sure that's the house where we were. Those duplicate newspapers that I keep trying to look at. That's the house. The stuff up there. But I don't... Can we get up there? Yeah, we can't get up there, at least without doing quite a bit more backtracking, and I don't want to do that. So let's check out the beach down there. We might end up there at some point anyway. That might be where the transmitter tower is. That might be our final destination, possibly. I mean, they would put it somewhere high up. Now, if this was real life, I'd be very afraid walking down here. All you had to do was one slip, and that would be it. If you were alive, you probably wouldn't be for long. You'd probably have all your limbs broken, head bashed in with a concussion. You'd be screwed up falling down there. Said I can speed this up a little, right? I love rocky shores. It's just something awesome about them. With all the spray from the sea and you see erosion at work. So another boat. Wow, this one's... Not much left on this one. You like what? That's spooky. I feel like we're in the innards of some beast. Its rib cage as its ribs coming up. Got me, partner.
Climbing down to the caves, I slipped and fell and have injured my leg.
What?
I think the femur is broken. It is clearly infected. The skin has turned a bright, tight pink, and the pain is crashing in on waves, winter tides against my shoreline, drowning out the ache of my stones.
What the hell?
I struggled back to the bothy to rest, but it has become clear that there is only one way this is likely to end. The medical supplies I looted from the trawler have suddenly found their purpose. They will keep me lucid for my final ascent.
The hell is that noise? I want to go in there, sort of, mostly. But let me see what's down here first. There's some demented beast that was in there. Spooky down here too. More Meridian histories. Maybe that's what was on the other boat. I will go into that cave. I hope that sound doesn't come back. It's pretty loud. I can only imagine once inside. It sounds almost musical out here. Like some kind of, like, low chime or something. No jump scares in here. I'm not hearing the sound now. Is that just part of the soundtrack during that voiceover? Was that him screaming because he broke his leg? Oh, awesome. He put the candles there. Oh, I love caverns like this. Awesome! Whee! No! I wanted to see what's up there. I thought this... What is up there?
From here, this last time, I have understood there is no turning back. The torch is failing along with my resolve. And hear the singing of the sea creatures from the passages above me, and they are promising the return of the gulls.
Oh.